guys. Welcome to my summer injury prevention video. My name is Crystal Bradkowski, and I'm a certified athletic therapist. Today, we're going to be talking about golf and golfer's elbow. So all you're going to need for today is a golf club, a light weight, or if you don't have a weight, you can also use a band instead. So if you've ever been golfing, I'm sure lots of you have experienced golfer's elbow. Basically, it's pain on the inside of the elbow here, from repetitive stress to the tendons of the forearm flexor muscles here. So today I'm going to be showing you some exercises and stretches that you can be doing at home to help prevent and reduce your risk of developing golfer's elbow. So with all the stretches and exercises that I'm going to show you guys, I'm going to demonstrate them all on one side. We'll do a full set on that side, and then you can pause the video and do the other side. The first thing I want to show you guys today is how to actually stretch out those forearm muscles. They can get really tight throughout the day, whether it's from work, if you're typing a lot, or if you're actually out golfing holding the golf club. And we want to keep them at that optimal muscle length. So a couple ways we're going to stretch this. The first is you're going to take your opposite hand and just pull your hand down just like this. So you should feel that kind of right in the top of your forearm here. You never want to push it too hard. It should feel like a good stretch. So let's hold this one for 6 breaths. So another way you can stretch out those forearm muscles is to actually stretch out kind of each individual finger here. So in the same position, you're going to grab one finger and gently pull it back. Good, and then we can switch to this finger. Good, let's go to this one. Good, and then the last one. Good. So another way we can stretch out those forearm muscles is to do both at the same time. So I'm gonna go over to my yoga mat. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna put your hands down on the ground with your fingertips pointing towards you or as close as you can. And then we're gonna gently lean into it. You don't, like I said, you don't wanna push it too hard. It should feel like a nice stretch. So I'll show you from this angle. There. And then gently rocking forward and back just a little bit. So as we come back, we increase the stretch, and as we come forward, we lighten it up a little bit. So next, I'm going to show you guys how to strengthen our forearm. So this exercise is going to have 2 parts to it. The first is to actually strengthen the muscles of the forearm. The second is to actually strengthen the tendon. So if our tendons or our muscles are too weak to handle the load that we're putting under it, you're more likely to get injured. So what you're going to do is you're going to grab your lightweight or your band and make sure you have a table or a desk near you, something that you can rest your arm on. Cool. So you're going to grab your weight, rest your arm on the table just so your wrist is kind of right at the edge of it. And you're going to start with your weight and your wrist kind of fully extended here. What we're going to do is we're going to curl that weight up just with our wrist, and then nice and slowly we're going to bring it back. You want to do like a 6 count on the way down. Good. So let's do a set of 10 of those. Good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Five more. Okay, 2 more. You should be feeling this right in your forearm here. Good. So I'm sure you guys felt the way up was fairly easy. But controlling on the way down is the hardest part, and that's where we're actually working on the tendon strength. So the next thing we're going to do works on kind of overall upper body strength as well as joint stability. So we're going to do an exercise called plank shoulder taps. So I'm going to demonstrate for you guys, and then we'll do them all together. But what we're going to do is get into a high plank. So you're going to be on your hands and feet. Make sure your back is nice and straight, your butt's not up in the air, your hips aren't hanging down. You want your hands right under your shoulders. And once you feel stable here, you're going to lift up one hand and touch your opposite shoulder. Now, if this is too hard for you, you can actually do this exercise on your knees as well. So you're going to be doing the exact same thing, just on your knees instead of your toes. So on your knees, leaning onto your hands, from your shoulders to your hips should be nice and straight. We don't want to be up on all fours like this. We're kind of leaning forward. And then same thing. You're going to touch your shoulder. Good. Cool. So this one you can do in time increments. So you'll kind of build up to 30 seconds or so. But to start, we're just going to do 10, so 5 on each side. Okay, so let's go. 1, 2, 3. So finally for today, we're going to go over your actual golf swing. Usually the mechanics of your movements and your swing can be what is the biggest cause of injury. So a couple things that I want to stress about the golf swing, and then I'll demo for you guys too, is so you want to avoid at the top of your swing, you don't want to break the swing, because what that causes usually is as you follow through, you end up flexing your forearm to hit the ball, rather than kind of using the whole motion of your body and your hips. So for this one, all you guys need is your golf club, or if you don't have access to your golf clubs, you can grab a broomstick or some sort of stick that would mimic your golf club. Okay, so when I talk about breaking the swing, so once you get into your setup, you're going to bring your club up. There's usually a point in your swing where you want to stop, because if you were to keep going, you're going to end up bending your wrist. We want to avoid the wrist bend. So we're going to come up, and from here, it's going to be our hips that bring the club through to hit the ball. Whereas if we bring our club back and break, what that ends up doing is, see how my wrists are bent as I come through? And now to hit the ball, I'm going to have to basically use my wrists to hit the ball. That puts a lot of stress on our elbow as we follow through. So you can practice this at home. It's a really good idea to videotape yourself, because then you can kind of break down your movements and see exactly what you're doing. Or if you can practice in front of a mirror. So just stop the top and then hips on the way through. So swing mechanics are something that athletic therapists such as myself can help you guys out with in the clinic. Because we're able to pick apart what you're doing and see the various biomechanical errors that you might be doing in your swing that can lead to injury. And we can help you correct those, as well as give you corrective exercises you can do at home to make sure that those errors don't keep happening. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Stay tuned for my next video. I'm going to be looking at a different injury and different summer activity. If you guys do have any questions or any specific injuries or activities you would like to see, feel free to email me at gameonathletictherapy.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.